Okay, I'm going to introduce myself to you. I'll take over since you're clearly confused. Okay, I'm Chelsea Handler.
Hi, Chelsea.
And you are?
Pedro Pascal.
Okay, yeah, you say it. Say it again louder.
Pedro Pascal.
Okay, and now you are a cocaine cowboy on the hunt for Pablo Escobar in your series, right? You're hunting him down?
Yeah, correct.
You filmed in Colombia, right?
We shot the whole thing in Colombia.
And how's that going on? What's going on down there?
It's pretty amazing. The base of production is in Bogota, and then we move around to different locations throughout the country. It's not totally easy to be away from home and shooting in these locations, but it's probably like the most important thing for the show to capture the era, and the only way to do it is to actually be there. And visually, that's the experience, you know. When I saw a little bit of the series, and it looks like it's Colombia in the 80s.
So you play what, like a police officer?
I'm a DEA agent.
And you're after, because he was a hard guy to find, right?
Yeah. Which is kind of hard to imagine, right? Because he was so huge and like really fat.
Well, also the interest, it's not like he could run fast. And so this is a series though, it's not a movie.
It's a series, it's a 10-episode series.
10-episode series, and the whole time you're looking for this guy. And is this your character based on a true guy?
It is a real guy.
It's not a real DEA.
No, he's a real DEA agent. I met him, he just retired in January 2014.
I'm surprised he didn't get killed by Pablo Escobar.
I know. It's two guys, Steve Murphy and Javier Peña, real living guys, and that headed the investigation for the DEA down there.
How do you like working for Netflix?
It's terrible.
It's embarrassing.
It's so
it's an embarrassing place to work.
It is. It's sort
of humiliating. It's like when people say, like, what network is it on? It's like, oh, God. I don't even want to say it.
Excuse me? Netflix! It's really embarrassing because I watch so much of it.
What are you watching?
I fucking watch all of it.
What's your...
I saw Bloodline. I saw Kimmy Schmidt.
See, Bloodline is like my favorite.
I was watching your stand-up. You've got to be kidding me. I've seen House of Cards. I'm caught up on Orange is the New Black. All of it. I'm a complete Netflix slave. Can I introduce you? I have to say hello.
Yeah.
Hello, Internet. I would like to introduce you to Chelsea Handler, Netflix's jack of all trades.
I'm doing four documentaries.
You're doing four documentaries?
Yeah. I'm almost done with them.
You've been shooting. Does that have anything to do with the amount of traveling you were telling me about before we started?
Yeah, I've been traveling all. I've been bopping around. I mean, I like to just kind of incorporate work with travel because I really can't sit still for very long. So I like to kind of explore at all times. So I did one, Chelsea Does Marriage was my first one, which is all about my personal feelings about marriage and exploring with my family. It was very personal. It was like talking to my ex-boyfriends, talking to people who've been married for like 65 years, talking to people who were in...
65 days.
Yeah, 65 days, exactly. People who are in like a throuple relationship, like two women and a man that like operate as a couple. Mm-hmm. It's called a throuple. That's a thing now.
I had no idea.
We did that. Chelsea Does Racism, which is fascinating. Chelsea Does...
Can't wait.
Silicon Valley, because I just don't understand anything about the tech world or how they operate. And then Chelsea Does Drugs is the last one. So I'm finishing.
Come to our show.
That's why I'm coming to
Maybe
to
that's
Columbia.
Why they put us together.
So I'm doing ayahuasca in Peru. That's the last thing I have left to shoot. I have like two more shoot days
left.
Have
you ever done it before?
No, of course not. I was waiting to do, I'm going to do it on camera.
You're going to do it on camera?
Yeah, that's what the point of this whole series is to show people everything I've done on camera, medically supervised, like taken Adderall, showed what happens to your brain, do like mental acuity, physical tests, taken an Ambien with lots of vodka to see in my own house. Like, I mean, it's not a pretty
documentary. To see everything that you're going to do and have, like, no memory of
just
whatsoever.
To show people how they behave when they're not acting
responsibly. You end up, like, writing emails and, like, calling people.
Or making a pot of spaghetti and then going for a drive in your car and not remembering anything.
Yeah. How did you convince Netflix to let you do it?
And I remember pitching the drug one to, you know, Netflix, Ted and Lisa and Cindy. And I was like, I think I should just do drugs and have everybody see what happens, how you act on weed and alcohol and pills and all the things that people abuse, you know, nothing really like illegal or narcotic because you can't really film that kind of stuff and get away with it.
Right.
And then, and there are certain places where you can film. And so ayahuasca obviously is legal in Peru. So they were like, I remember Ted was like, yeah.
And that seems to be Netflix's MO.
Do you like the people that you work with?
Yes, very much.
Or would you like to see some of
them?
They
aren't that funny. I'm the funny one.
Are you?
Maybe, possibly.
You think you make a lot of people laugh?
Yeah. Or cry. But what's the difference?
Nothing. They're very similar. It's a very fine line.
So then what are you
Don't worry about me. I'm a very loud personality. It's more important that we interviewed you. Everybody knows what's going on.
No, this is so much fun. I got to kind of interview you.
Yeah, you did a little bit, but I controlled the interview.
Which is, you controlled the interview?
Because I know what I'm doing.
But you do know what you're doing.
Thank you.
I do not.
It was really fun. It was a pleasure to meet you. I like you.
It was a pleasure to meet you, too. I like you, too.
Yeah, great. We're going to go. Can we get a bag of blow?